Hello. On today's episode of Less Code, More Power, Roma Gupta is going to tell us how to automate all the things, including your plant's existence. Hello, and welcome back to Less Code, More Power. I'm one of your hosts, Dona Sarah, and this lovely human over here is Sarah Critchley.
Hey, everyone. How you doing?
Today, we have a fantastic guest with us. Roma Gupta is joining us from Johannesburg, one of my favorite places on the planet, where we both wish we were right now with you. Today, she's going to be sharing us the secret of how Power Automate will take over the world, because you can automate everything. Roma, please join us.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Donna. Hi, Sarah.
Hey.
We are so excited you're joining us today.
I am. I mean, I have like two superheroes with me today.
That is so sweet. Okay, so tell everyone who you are and what you do.
I'm Roma Gupta, joining from Johannesburg. I am a Dynamics 365 Power Platform consultant. I literally break applications. So I have more than, 25 Microsoft tickets open already and closed as well. Microsoft has been so grateful to me, and today I'm going to show you some exciting things as well.
Fabulous. So we hear you're a huge fan of Power Automate, and Automate can like make people's lives so much easier at work, but also at home. Do you want to share with us your story of how you got into Power Automate and what is this project you're doing that involves plants?
Yeah. So I've been using the Power Automate in project work, right? And on the side after office hours, and then when you want to relax, actually. So I have got a little small garden with me at home. But sometimes I care, sometimes I forgot, and then I've got insecticides and running again all over to get all those plants fixes. So I said, let's automate my garden back and bring it back to life, actually, using Power Automate. So, and I did it, and I made it. It was not even like 30 minutes or so. I made the Power Automate, I left it running, and now I'm gonna show you at the end some cool stuff and how the plants are bringing back to life using Power Automate as well.
I love that. That's amazing. Like, I love that you've taken your experience and your expertise from your work, like that you'll have seen Power Automate used in pretty much every industry, right? Like that's like, you've got so much knowledge, so much experience from that, but now you're saying it can actually help like your life, right? Like your personal life, like plants. And I love that you're bringing it back to agriculture. I think that's great.
Mm-hmm. That is really cool.
Yes.
So show us now mm-hmm. that you've used us.
Yeah, I could use this. Yes. I'm looking forward to using this solution to make sure I don't kill every plant that I own.
Yes, so I've seen it like in every industry. So let me quickly share you my Power Automate, which is helping me with my plants. To be very honest, I have a quick like three steps, but it's gonna go in deep dive quickly. It's a reoccurring one. So it tells me every Saturday in the evening that Roma, you have to do this thing, like, you know, and I'm going to show you my source file as well. It's evening because it is insecticides and pesticides. So I take care of the bees and the flowers small insects that come in during the day for flowering and blooming. And then it goes to my source table. I have a source table on the Excel. It's basically the two things that I apply to my plant, insecticide and a neem oil that is biodegradable. And I go back to my Power Automate. So it's literally just bring those things back. The main thing is the condition over here, which I have, right? So there's a condition, it checks for the 7 days thing. So it checks when was the last thing applied. If the last thing was insecticide, this time I have to apply the neem oil, right? So it goes like that in a recursive way. And then when it comes back, whatever comes back, it sends me an email on my personal email. And it says, reminder to take care of the plants. Mm-hmm. And I've set all the fancy fonts. And it says, love Power Automate to show all the love. And it also fetches the medicine name. And it gives me on what date I've applied so that... And then it goes back and applies that same date back to my Excel. So I have my entire schedule ready for my plants to take care.
That's epic.
That is adorable. I love the signature, the cute font. That is so cool because this is not just an annoying reminder email. You're kind of delighted to get it.
Exactly. And the email comes in this format. So it's not some cheesy, old, boring email, right? Mm-hmm. I've taken it as read. I've sent the fonts. You can easily bold it. And even if you want to apply the importance, you can do that easily. And let me also show you something very special mm-hmm. that the plants have given me back, right? So the things we do in community, we give it back. So I have given it back to the nature as well. And here it is.
Wow.
Whoa. Those are gorgeous.
That is such a lovely plant.
That is a beautiful gradient of color on that flower thing. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I don't understand how you have these plants. Why? I can't even keep it like a cactus, dude. Like, no, I can't. They're beautiful. They're stunning.
Yeah, they
They're
are.
They're like grass purple. So I'm really happy about this.
Yes. So we went this, we saw this, and we grabbed it. So this plant over here was almost dead of the infection that came from the rose plant, basically. And the pictures now is after applying those care and neem oil and all those insecticides, the plant food, basically. And this is the final result, which you are seeing right now.
That's amazing. I love that you've created, it's kind of what you said, Donna, like you've not created something that you're just going to ignore. It's kind of annoying. Like, I mean, we don't enjoy getting emails, right? Like, especially like thousands a day or whatever it ends up being. You've kind of, I'm a big fan of removing barriers for people to do stuff. So if you make it easy for something to happen, then it's more likely going to happen. And this is kind of what you've done, right? You've used Power Automate to make it easy to remind yourself to kind of do something.
Yeah.
That's so awesome. Like, you can kind of use a similar pattern for pretty much anything, right?
Yes, anything, everywhere, anywhere, I should say.
Yeah, so you can be like, take your meds, give your cat her meds, remember to do household chores, file your taxes, you know, pay this monthly thing. There's just so many things. You know what I learned today that was so eye-opening, and I should know that, but I didn't, that you can set creative font and color in Power Automate. Mm. Did not know that. I think of Outlook as a monolithic thing, like Outlook.
I can just imagine how dangerous you're going to be now, Donna. You're going to be like, you're going to open up Power Automate after this episode and start coloring things.
All mails are fuchsia, so further notice.
I'm going to get these pink emails from you, like.
Fuchsia.
Oh man, this is a beautiful plan. Yeah, I just think that this is great because it's almost like situational, like you said, like if you're like something like this that you need to kind of nurse something back to health or just permanently as well. It's like a kind of general reoccurrence. And it seems so simple. Roma, how long did it take for you to make this?
Honestly, 30 minutes.
Wow.
Wait, what? Okay.
That's pretty epic.
Yeah.
And it worked. It worked in 30 minutes. Like it was like, that's it. Done.
Yeah, it was, that's it. Just do this. So I created a source file. I was honestly doing it like using variables, but I was like, no, because I want to also know which date I applied what as a backtrack check. So I use the Excel because I use it so frequently in my daily life. I use the Excel, put it on the Power Automate, and then the condition on how frequently I want to use it. That's it. And the email sends, the dates is automatically applied. Done.
That's nice. Excel just makes it so much accessible, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This is great. So tell us, we've heard you've got some homework for us. Like, what's the action that you want to, because I know that you are really active in the community, Roma. Like, you do so much stuff like groups and community stuff, like involvement. Can you tell everyone about that? And then what's the homework for the audience today?
I have a very special homework for every one of you out there who are seeing this right now. I want to tell you this. Join the Power Platform community first, okay? And leverage the use of Power Automate as well in your daily life and everywhere. You know, don't need everything to be told by your boss and officially signed. Just make your work effective and efficient, and also take care of your teammates as well using Power Automate. And then you can use your extra time for the coffee and for your loved ones. And for the homework, do this, join the community, get to know your pain area, automate it, and then follow D365 champs, because I'm also the lead of there. And then maybe I can give you a chance to showcase your demo at our meetup.
I love this. First organization, plant matching gradient.
I know. I love this. I kind of feel like I need to get this deck from you.
Really nice deck. I love these colors. So interesting. You're like, Roma, you are a hero. Okay, Roma. Thank you so much for joining us today. This is beautiful.
This is great. Well, thank you so much. This is awesome. So with that in mind, thank you to the audience for watching. All of the links that Roma just talked about will be down in the description. So yeah, and please do reach out if you have any questions. So with that in mind, less code.
More power.
Yeah.